everything going on, right? Internally and externally. Yeah.
Well, first, I manage with stress by just, usually I like to focus on things like a day at a time. Like if it's a really stressful period and a lot of things are going on, I'll just know like, oh, this is what I have to do in this day. But knowing what's coming up next and not thinking about everything at once, because then I get too overwhelmed. And then with the rest of the cab, if they're stressed, like we're gonna get stressed out. This is a stressful thing. We're in school too. But just knowing that you're not alone in it. There's other people there who you can fall back on and depend on.
Hello. When will you start appointing the position? And what would you do if you can't find a person for those appointed positions? Such as the PCN director, film fest director, moderator, or other. Also conference funding.
If we really can't find anybody for it, then I think we would share the work as CAB to make it successful, rather than like, picking just one person on CAB.
And when would you do it?
Sorry?
When would you start, like, appointing those positions?
No, when was this? Well, before the next school year. Before or after bank?
So, what would you do if your cabinet end up not liking each other?
Well, we don't all have to be friends, but we do need to know that when we're here, this is a professional environment, and you at least have to be civil with each other to be able to work with each other.
So given that those running for board are kind of young and haven't had really like a board experience, burnout is real, like it's really real, and with a young board it's kind of more of a risk, not risk, like, more of a something that will happen because you're young, you're eager to put like 100% into the club, so that means burnout can happen first semester. Like some people they can pace themselves and it'll happen second semester. Like do you kind of have a game plan on what to happen if someone burns out? Because for when someone burns out, they really just do not want to be a part of it anymore. They don't want any contact like whatsoever. Like do you have kind of a game plan?
Like you said, burnout's inevitable and we can prepare as much as we can, but we never know what's gonna happen. But I think the biggest thing is just knowing that it's something that can possibly be coming will still help us prepare a little bit, because that way when it does come, we're not completely blindsided and stressed out over it.
Alright. Why do you think GBRS coach are meetings?
Like I said in my speech, I kept coming as a GB member because there was just something about PSA. And I think that, like when I saw the current cab now, like you guys were really close and you promoted a very welcoming environment. And I think that's what keeps GB members from, or keeps GB members coming back.
What is your style of leader or a managing group of people?
My style as a leader is always taking into consideration everyone else's opinions and reaching a compromise from there, because maybe sometimes my vision isn't what someone else's vision is and we need to find a halfway point there.
How would you improve meetings to be more efficient? CAB meetings and general body meetings?
CAB meetings, I think I would encourage that everyone says something and gives an opinion on something rather than just the same people every time. And keeping with the, like, during pros, cons, and deltas, keeping a time limit for things. And then with GBMs, again, just being aware of time and maybe planning out the times for each slide beforehand and making sure that everyone knows.
If elected, what are your biggest worries for the next year term, the new year term, and then how we tackle those issues?
I think my biggest worry is that how others view me, because I am a first year, and technically I do have a year of experience on board by being an intern, but you know, it's not the same as being on board. But in order to tackle it, I just want to present myself as professionally and as determined and dedicated as possible.
How would you handle member retention, like at the beginning of the school year and throughout the year?
I would, again, remind our cab that we have to be welcoming to our members, because once they see that it's a welcoming environment, then they're going to feel more compelled to open up and feel like they want to be there. And also, we should table as much as we can, reach out to other orgs, also go to their GBM and invite people to come.
Are there any other questions?
This is a question from Kevin Mai. How would you handle if two or more board members dropped?
First, I would try to see if there's someone qualified who could help us out with that position. And if there really, really isn't somebody, then we'd have to divide up that work between captains.
Any other questions? So my final question is, as president, no matter what happens, and no matter who does what, you're always the one to pick up the slack. You're always the one to get the short end of the straw. How do you feel about that? And what will keep you motivated going through the tough times?
I'm definitely as prepared as I can be to do that. I'm taking 12 units next semester, and then part of your question?
Yeah. As president, you're picking up the slack, so you always get the short end of the straw, so you always have to do some of the hardest stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So how are you going to deal with that, considering you're a first year?
Personally, sacrifice, but that's what it thought to be made. I know that. And I think the biggest thing is not losing sight of my vision for ESA and why I ran in the first place. And I think that is what would keep me motivated.
Excellent. Okay. If there are no more questions, thank you.